of the matter is that the political people don't really care whether there is a censor board or not, because in many parts of our country, especially in Tamil Nadu, the government believes that they are the first and
Tanvi,
the last
Tanvi,
word. That is it. That
the
nothing.
Law and order is a state subject.
There was the only people creating law and order issue, Mr. Rajshekaran, were the government people.
The state has to take care of it.
The state, the only people creating law and order issue were the government people. Everybody else is loving
the
movie. They have gone and watched the movie. The movie is doing business of over 50 crore. What are you talking about?
You have a political motive and intention behind it. So you are assassinating the reputation and the character of the ex-former chief ministers, both Karunanidhi and Jayalalitha. You have spoiled their hard-earned reputation.
You know, even the DMK doesn't think that Karunanidhi's reputation was getting spoiled by it.
That is the reason.
Even DMK doesn't think so, and it doesn't matter what political workers think. They are not the decision makers of this country. That is not the common man speaking. The common man is going and watching the movie and loving it. I will request you to open up and look at the bookings and the advance bookings, not only in Tamil Nadu, even in the city of Mumbai. Right now, you will not get a ticket to go and watch the movie because people are going and watching the movie. So that's about it. Because this is a movie viewing experience. This is about movie viewing experiences. This is not about winning and losing election. Now, if the political leadership in Tamil Nadu is so insecure that they think two dialogues out of a Vijay movie is going to bring them down, then I really don't know why they are in power any which ways. Here are a few more examples of why the state of Tamil Nadu and its government have become experts in crushing dissent. Example number one. There was a massive massacre that took place in the month of May this year. After 100 days of people peacefully protesting in Tuticorin, the government decided to open fire at them. People died. In Salem, where the chief minister wants to build this fancy 8-lane project, highway project, he wants to railroad the sentiments and the demands of the common people. They started arresting protesters, peaceful tribals and farmers who were simply asking for better compensation for a dialogue with the government, which, by the way, the court then reminded the government you have to do. But if it was AIADMK's way, they would have just gone ahead and arrested all of them like they did. Here are a few more examples of what really has happened in the recent past. Freelance cartoonist Mr. Bala G made this cartoon with a caricature of the chief minister, and all hell came breaking loose. Because, oh my God, how can you have a cartoon about the chief minister of Tamil Nadu? How dare you question the chief minister of Tamil Nadu? And he was sent to jail. Poets are being sent to jail. Writers are being sent to jail. Cartoonists are being sent to jail. Movies are being censored. There is protest on the street. People are being shot for questioning the government. That is what is happening in the state of Tamil Nadu. And I find it very hard to believe and even accept the fact that there are people sitting here and backing this kind of a government. I really don't understand how that's happening.